Hello students, how are you all? I just hope that you all are well. Now students, we will continue with the same chapter, chapter 1, the skeletal system. Now we have done joints and I told you about synovial cavity also. Now comes types of joints. Now there are mainly two types of joints. What are they? Movable joint and immovable joint. Now, what are movable joint? As the name suggests, movable, that means where movement occurs, and immovable, where no movement occurs. So movable joint is a type of joint where movement occurs, okay? And immovable joint are the types of joint where no movement occurs. Then comes the second point of difference is a synovial cavity is absent. Now students, I told you about synovial cavity. What is it? This cavity is actually found in the places of joints where movement occurs, like your knee joint, your elbow joint, etc. And what this synovial cavity does? It stores synovial fluid, which helps in movement, or it acts as a shock absorber also. So in movable joint, a synovial cavity is absent, and in immovable joint, a synovial cavity is present. Then comes third point of difference. It includes all joints except the bones of skull. Now movable means movement. Now in skull, you know, there is no movement, so it includes all the joints in the body except the bones of skull. And in immovable joint, since no movement occur in this type of joint, so it includes the bones of skull. So these are the three point of differences between movable and immovable joint. Now students, movable joints, they also have types. Now there are four types of movable joints. What are they? Ball and socket joint. The second one is hinge joint. Third one is pivot joint. And the fourth one is gliding joint. Now we will learn about these joints one by one. Now let us take ball and socket joint first. Ball and socket joint. Now in this type of joint, the ball shaped, and you can see this, mostly bones, they have a ball shaped end. Now the ball shaped end of one bone, it fits into the cup shape. You can see this, it is shaped like a cup shaped socket of other bone. It fits into the cup shaped socket of other bone. This is known as ball and socket joint. Now, because of this ball and socket joint, we can move our arms forward, backward, upward and downward, or in all the directions. The same way, it allows the movement of our legs also, because it is present in hip, which is called hip joint. So we can move our legs forward, backward, then upward and downward. So, this type of joint, ball and socket joint, they are present in shoulder joint and hip joint. Now, the second type of joint is hinge joint. Now, it acts like a hinge of the door. Now, hinge of the door, what it does, it allows the door to move backward and forward like this. The same way, this joint, it is present in our elbows and knees, then and ankles. So it allows the movement in backward and forward direction like this. You can see like this, it doesn't go beyond that. It cannot rotate like this, like your arms rotate like this, but this joint, this arm, it cannot go beyond that. It just go backward and forward like this. Okay, so this joint, It is present in elbows, knees and ankles. And it allows only backward and forward movement. Then comes pivot joint. Now this type of joint, it occurs at the base of the neck. Now this is your neck, suppose, and it occurs between the first and second vertebrae. Vertebrae, you know, vertebrae, it is the bone which is present in a vertebral column. What is vertebral column? Your backbone. So it is present at the first and second vertebrae. It allows sideways movement, you know, because of this joint we can move our head to the left, then right, up and down. So this is known as pivot joint. And now the last type or the fourth type of movable joint is gliding joint. Now what do you mean by gliding? That means to move smoothly or continuously. Now in this type of joint, bones, they glide against each other, but they cannot move in circular direction. Like other joints, they don't move like that. They just glide against each other. Examples of gliding joint is bones in vertebral column. This is a vertebral column and it is found, it is present in vertebral column. And this is the least movable joint. Now students, I know that you all love sports. You love climbing, you love playing, you love running. And all these activities, all these movements, they are controlled by muscles. Now what are muscles? Muscles are soft tissues that are present in human body. And these muscles, along with bones, they give shape to our body. And they also help in different parts of body to make the movements. So just now I told you love climbing. So they help in the movement of leg. You love pulling things. They help there also in arms. So there are over 600 different muscles. They are present in an adult human body. Now these muscles, they are based on their functions. They are of two types: voluntary and involuntary muscles. Now comes its types. Based on the functions, muscles, they are divided into two types: voluntary muscles and involuntary muscles. Voluntary muscles are the types of muscles whose movement can be controlled by us. Suppose if we want to eat something, what we do? We grab that thing and then we eat. So this activity, this movement is controlled by us. So this is voluntary activity or voluntary movement. Or suppose if we want to run, if we want to jump, if we want to sit, all these movements, they are controlled by us. So the muscles of arms, legs, hands, feet, they all are voluntary muscles. Then comes involuntary muscles. Just opposite to voluntary muscles, these muscles, their movement cannot be controlled by us, and they work on their own. They are further divided into two types: smooth muscles and cardiac muscles. Now the two types of involuntary muscles are smooth muscles and cardiac muscles. Now smooth muscles and cardiac muscles both are involuntary in nature. That means they are not under our control. So smooth muscles, they are found in most of the internal organs. Internal organs means the organs that are present inside our body. For example, they are present in stomach and intestine. You know, digestion process, it happens in stomach and intestine, and the digestion of food, it is not controlled by us. So this is involuntary muscle. Now comes cardiac muscles. These muscles, cardiac means related to heart. So these muscles, they are found in the walls of heart. And you know, heart, it continuously, what it does, it pumps the blood. So it works throughout our life. They are tireless muscles also.
Now students, these are the question answers that you will be doing in your notebook. The first question is, what are movable joints and where are they present in our body? The second question is, what are immovable joints and where are they present in our body? The third question is, explain the following types of joints and give an example. You have to explain these joints and then you have to write an example in each case. You have to give an example in each case. Then, fourth question is, what are muscles? How many muscles are present in our body? Then question number 5 is, differentiate between any, you have to give any two differences between voluntary and involuntary muscles. And then second one is smooth muscles and cardiac muscles.